Thanks.
I was talking to Mawas.
Oh, thank you.
Shit.
It's still it's still just the Type 55 breach gear. I just dyed it.
It's really cute, though. I really like that that outfit.
Thank you. I thought these colors would be nice.
Yeah. I like olive green is a good color for Mawas.
Yeah, I think this one is adamantoids.
Hmm.
And the hat is slightly different, turquoise, so it just didn't look like so.
Oh, now that you've pointed it out, though. Now that you pointed out
that it's adamantoids, I fucking hate it.
I use kicker and brown for the leather, and then like her little shorts underneath are little brown. I was going for like a little bit of a yellowish khaki look.
Gotcha. Yeah, it looks nice.
Thank you. And I thought the blade would be cool in brass.
Ooh, yeah. What sword is that?
That's the Crypt Lurker's augmented. I was working. Oh. This is what I was working on. So basically all my gear is really good to go for next time.
Gotcha. Well, it seems we're live. Like that weird dead air has passed. So do y'all want to introduce yourselves?
Yeah, sure. Hey everyone, how's it? This is your favorite Laheim, and I'm here with Crow doing this.
Yeah.
Hey, I'm Care. I'm here, and I'm doing this. And I think that's everything for me.
Care is a professional musician.
Roll back.
Have you made money doing music that makes you a professional musician?
Let me just check.
Check if I've made money with music. I've been playing Final Fantasy for a long time.
And I was telling the other two that I am a classically trained musician. And I almost said I speak six instruments. I am fluent in six instruments.
I speak six instruments. Ha! That was a fucking trumpet!
Yeah, I speak six instruments. That's the line we're going with.
Time to hear the music man talk about music. Hey, yeah.
So yeah, for those that caught the stream yesterday, you may have heard me mention that speaking 12/8 time get good. Why on earth would I do that? No.
It goes fast? Is 12/8 over? Is 12/8 fast?
No. 12/8 is a measure of how you count each measure of music. So, like, let's say common time is called 4/4 time, where you have 4 beats per measure, and then the beat restarts. So, like, 1, 2, 3, 4, 2, 2, 3, 4, 3, 2, 3, 4, etc., etc., etc. It's just a way of, like, how you read the music to make sure that the timing is correct.
Hey, everyone. I know a lot about music.
And then, so, if 4/4 was this, I can't snap that quickly. 12 would be, I sped up my left hand because I can't do it with two hands. I can do it on guitar, I can't do it on...
It's a stupid time signature, and I'm angry that you brought it up this early in the stream, Cam. How dare you? It's ridiculous. I hate it.
Oh, it's a pretty big creature. That's what I know.
Yeah. True.
But yeah, I had mentioned yesterday that Masayoshi Soken had won a Guinness World Record, which is true.
Ooh. Oh, shit.
Yeah.
Yeah, I want to know about this.
It's also like not the only Guinness World Record associated with 14 or the Final Fantasy series as a whole, as I was fact-checking this earlier today. Back in 3.4, patch 3.4, he held the world record for the most, number of songs in a video game soundtrack. 14, like, Yoshida took the award for longest credits in a video game. the end of 2.0, because they included all the players who played in, 1.0 and, like, came back and played the legacy games and whatnot.
That's
and
awesome.
Then, Final Fantasy as a franchise has the record for, let me see the exact phrasing here, one second. from Nova Crystallis, if anybody wants to look this up. The final award was presented to Square Enix president and CEO Yosuke Matsuda on behalf of the entire Final Fantasy franchise. The award, Most Prolific Role-Playing Series, represents the 87 titles in that now compose the franchise, which that has gone up since then because this was 2017.
Dang. Jeez. That's so many titles. What the heck?
Yeah, and as of whatever patch that was, it was like most of the way through Heaven's Word, 384 tracks.
My gosh. Just in Heaven's Word.
Yeah, just in A Realm Reborn, and like parts of A Realm Reborn in Heaven's Word.
We're almost an Endwalker. That number has to have at least doubled.
Possibly tripled, because Shadowbringers had a long soundtrack.
Yeah.
So yeah, just to kind of springboard off of that though, how do you do that? Like, what is the method to doing that many tracks and having all of them be unique and interesting and relevant to the part that they're in? The way I've always phrased it is that Masayoshi Soken is a gentleman. He never met a melody he didn't call back after the first date. And what I mean by that is he reuses melodies, and they're called leitmotifs and like themes from music everywhere.
So, Crow, I need to ask you this.
Go for it.
Because I had to look it up, but I want to hear it from you. What is a leitmotif?
So the leitmotif is like the underlying theme of a song. And I was trying to think of examples where this was relevant. So like take the boss theme from Shadowbringers, where you have the where you have that recurring melody. That's the leitmotif, where it's reused to recreate the theme in connected pieces of music. Does that make sense?
Yeah, that does make sense.
Yeah, he's really, really big on calling back different themes and bits and pieces of other songs, like as far back as A Realm Reborn.
I can definitely see that. Yeah, that does happen a lot. So that's cool. I like that.
I think it's one of his biggest strengths as a composer. And I say A Realm Reborn specifically because when I was leveling Dark Knight not too long ago, I got Sestasia for leveling roulette. Mm-hmm. And then I got Anamnesis Anitor for my level 80 roulette. And I'm like listening to the music, waiting for the first trash to come through. And I'm sitting there going, hang on. Hold up. This is familiar. And it turns out that Anamnesis Anitor is just Sestasia but funky.
Yeah, it's just jazzed up.
It really is.
Yeah, you pointed that out to me the other day, and then I went to go listen to the songs, and I'm like, whoa, that's nuts. They really are.
Yeah. Or, like, when we were practicing Ruby Weapon, that song was in the Praetorium at the end of 2.0, and it got remixed for Uwu, and then recovered again the rock theme for Ruby Weapon. And, like, he does that a lot. But the other thing that I had put down on my little note for this is that that's not the only time that he does that.
Yeah.
Kara, you caught up with Story by chance?
No, dude.
Okay. No,
dude. I just came back 2 days ago.
That's fair. So I may screen share with you parts of this. But he draws from like other composers and other artists like throughout history. He has snuck in The Sorcerer's Apprentice by Paul Dukas, not once, but twice. And I can't believe that nobody has called him out on this. the first being, of course, Metoya's Relict is the obvious version of that, which we'll pop into explore mode in a second here. And then if you listen to the All Saints Wake theme song, Up at Dawn, everybody goes, oh yeah, that's just the Addams Family, but he pulls bits and pieces of that same theme from the Sorcerer's Apprentice too, and I, you know, listening through, getting myself hyped up to do this, and I'm like, wait a second. And I noticed that I do that a lot, listening to these soundtracks, which all of them minus Death Unto Dawn are available to stream. What is happening in my chat?
Yeah, very much. Jesus. I was going to say, for anybody, like, I'd very much recommend just, like, because the way that I enjoy Final Fantasy's music is that I don't play games with music on.
That's fair.
I know it's somewhat criminal to a lot of people, but I listen to them on my own time. Like, if I'm taking I have a lot of transit to do per day, I'll just stick it on when I'm doing that. When I'm walking or whatever. And then, like, it allows me to focus in, because, that's, like, a major complaint that I have. I know it's not about Endwalker, but, like, about games that I type like that, where it's, like, you have a very stressful situation that you're in, coming from, like, you know, Bloodborne and Dark Souls, and you're like, this music's really good. You'll never be able to focus on it, because you're getting your ass beat by this giant creature who hates you and wants to see you dead. Yeah. So you won't get a time to focus on it.
Yeah, a perfect example of that is the Tower of Paradigm's breach. Because I remember the day the patch dropped and we were all running for the first time. And I remember going, oh wow, that's Kainé's theme from Nier and Nier Replicant. I wasn't sure what they were going to do with it. And it took me, like, I had to go look it up and listen to it later to realize that, oh, he crossed it over with the Final Fantasy main theme from Final Fantasy 1. Mm-hmm. Like, I was too busy getting thrown across the horizon by a building cocked at me.
It's hard to hear the songs when you're screaming and everyone else is screaming.
Yeah, so, like, that's what I think about, like, especially most music like this of its type, is, like, being able to not just listen to it once it's in its context, but without it, I think just goes to show how powerful a piece of music is, regardless of the soundtrack.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I agree.
But yeah, definitely take some time out of your day. The Shadowbringers soundtrack on Spotify is like 5 hours long, so you know, just take it in strides, but worth a listen to inside of game.
I glanced earlier, and I have a playlist that's just called Warrior of Light on my phone, and it's all the my favorite tracks and a couple of covers. It is 97 songs long, 8 hours and 11 minutes, and I have not updated it recently.
Wow, that's huge. That's so much time.
I work a lot of hours where I'm allowed to listen to headphones at work.
True.
So I do have that advantage of, like, I can sit and just, like, binge this playlist. But, like Kara said, it really is worth sitting down and listening to a lot of these songs without the, you know, to use the phrase, the heat of battle. Because you miss stuff. Like, the running joke with Ruby Weapon, just to bring it back around, was, you know, the misheard lyrics. But there's real English lyrics in that song.
It's not just saying beef soft tacos over and over again?
Mm-mm.
Yeah. Wow.
Yeah, they referenced the Heart of Sabeek in that one fight in the Praetorium. And then never again until the Uwu fight. And then again in the Ruby Weapon, the Ultima Primals version. It's the only other times that has shown up in the continuity of the game.
That's amazing. That's because, like, not even the vaunted scholars of Valak can scratch the surface.
But yeah, the lyrics are definitely interesting, too. It talks about, like rend the shield of light, salvation, destruction, Ultima. Like, it's really worth looking up and finding a transcription somewhere.
Mm-hmm.
Which I think is the case for every song that has lyrics in this game.
Yeah, the lyrics in this game are pretty on point as to what's happening on the story and stuff like that.
Mm-hmm. Well, I'm going to shout out another content creator. Please, if you have not followed him on YouTube, please go subscribe to Alex Mukala immediately.
Yes.
He does amazing. He's, a professional musician, like, works for, I think one of his film credits was he worked on Avengers Endgame, which, holy crap.
Yeah, that's huge.
Yeah. He does really, really good breakdowns of the way that the music is structured and the way that the instruments are used, and it's called rests, where you have a beat of no sound. Mm-hmm. But the way that, like, notes and rests are used in different pieces. Like, he broke down the twinning along Fall really well. And that's the one I recommend you start with. All of this to say, I thought I had something. I was Charlie Day with my conspiracy board earlier. Because he had done the analysis of the Final Fantasy 16 soundtrack. And I'm like, hey, hang on a second. This all sounds really, really familiar somehow. And I didn't find anything of it, but my crackpot tinfoil hat conspiracy theory is that Final Fantasy 16 is the next MMO. It's not, but...
Yeah.
Yeah.
Just over here wearing a tinfoil hat. Also, if you're interested in people doing stuff like that, the person that I'm going to recommend is TPR on Spotify and everything like that. They do a ton of like remixes of stuff like that.
Mm-hmm.
They unfortunately haven't done 14, but they do a lot of like they do all the melancholy music from like certain games, and then just make them into like these really, really beautiful pieces.
Mm-hmm.
I played a lot of Final Fantasy X when I was younger, so he does like, you know, melancholy of like Final Fantasy X or like some certain other games.
Oh, speaking of
Chrono Trigger, super good.
We're gonna teleport to Kugane.
Ooh, let's go to Kugane.
Because this ties back into what is a leitmotif. Oh, it's nighttime. I don't know if we'll be able to hear it. Let me turn my music up.
You said that artist was called TPR, Care?
Yeah, TPR.
Yeah.
Also, they do, I know it's not Final Fantasy, but they do one of Ocarina of Time and one of Chrono Trigger. Warth, you know?
That's pretty sweet.
Yeah, also they do one of Hollow Knight. I think Hollow Knight's just underrated in all forms.
Yeah, I don't think I'll be able to hear it at this point in the evening. I don't think it plays in this song. There is a little tiny piece of the Kugane Day music that is pulled from the song Tsuteki Dane from Final Fantasy X. Oh no, here it is. It's one little tiny half a measure, but as soon as I heard it, I'm like, oh, that's brilliant. It has no real bearing on the rest of the story, but it's just the little touch that they put into stuff like that. Ooh, thank you. I will listen to that
later. I just sent it to them, because I was thinking about it.
Yeah, I'll listen to that after. Again, I don't know. I had it and I lost it. I'm sorry. It's been a long day.
We're talking about the references to 10 in the music.
Yeah, like and we talked about this in story yesterday too. It's just the little touches here and there that really, really take this game from good to great.
Mm-hmm.
I think my favorite of like them referencing themselves is like whatever song is in Amarant. Mm-hmm. I don't remember.
Mm-hmm.
And then Spoiler of Light, during the Warrior of Light fight, the clock's ticking continuously, and I was like, that's some good shit.
I was actually thinking about that one earlier today. What I did was I put like the soundtracks on shuffle and just hyped myself up for this, because I love talking about this stuff. I remember when Shadowbringers first came out, and we first got to Amarant, and I heard that theme in the city itself, and I remember thinking to myself, this feels like it should have lyrics. Like, I just had that thought of, like, this is set up to be a song with vocals. And then, surprise, surprise, a year later, we got To the Edge. For those curious, the song from Amarant is called Mortal Instance. Instances. Mortal Instances. Yeah.
Mortal Instance.
Yeah. I was close. I had it right the first time.
And the one that plays in, like, the area of Amarant is called Neath Dark Waters, which is, I believe, the basis for all of them.
Yeah. I haven't found anything super compelling, I guess. It's not the right word, but the word I'm going for as far as, like, song titles go. They're mostly just references to, like, whatever you're fighting at the point, or whatever area you're in. But sometimes you get a song like Mortal Instant or To the Edge, and you go, wow, that's a powerful title for a powerful song.
Speaking of titles, a lot of the tracks in Shadowbringers sort of, like, play off each other's in terms of titles as well.
Mm-hmm.
So the Final the Shadowbringers boss theme is called Insatiable. But then you also have riffs off of that, like in the fight with Vothrian Innocence called Insanity.
Mm-hmm.
And I think that's really cool. There's a few others that use In as its starting name. I believe the one in Hades also starts with In.
Invincible?
Invincible, yeah.
Invincible.
I liked that big male chorus at the login screen. Mm-hmm. Is called Fourfold Knowing, which is taken from the Shadowbringers main theme.
That I didn't know about.
Yeah, Shadowbringers was the first soundtrack that I spent money on to purchase from the iTunes store instead of other means, shall we say.
You need on Spotify.
Yeah, now it's on Spotify, and we're going to put poor Mecha D out of a job. A pillar of the community, honestly. That dude is so quick.
Mm-hmm. I mean, you still can't listen to Pulse on Spotify, so...
Yeah, that's, you know, true. What I mean? That's true.
Yeah.
You can only listen to two singles, I do believe, on Spotify. Mm-hmm. Like, the...
Yeah, you can listen to What Angel Wakes Me and whatever Leviathan's theme is called.
I'm a big scary snake monster.
Yeah,
I think it's called.
I'm a big scary
it's,
snake
monster. You know what? I can look it up because I downloaded those. I think it is called Maelstrom.
Into the Maelstrom?
Through the Maelstrom. Yeah. But one more thing I want to talk about while we're on this subject of reusing themes is just how, like, and Alex did a really good breakdown, but what he didn't touch on that I wish he would have is how meta A Long Fall is. It is a cover of a cover of a remix of a cover from another Final Fantasy song.
Yeah, it's nuts.
Yeah. It has, like, three other themes mixed into it, too. Like, the amount of work that went into pulling all of these different themes together was just nuts. But...
Are you playing A Long Fall right now?
No. I have the game music going. Because I don't want to get pinged for copyright.
Want to play some A Long Fall?
Yeah, let's pop into Explorer mode.
Also, I don't think, because it's Final Fantasy music, that they will ping you.
That's true. I don't want to risk it though when we have other options. Let's see. Explorer mode. Carrie, do you have the twinning unlocked?
Do I have the twinning unlocked?
Yeah.
Yes.
Would you like to come with?
I am currently not available to use my PlayStation.
That's entirely fair.
I do believe my roommate is watching something.
That's entirely fair.
Also, you guys were saying like motifs for songwriting. I can personally say that naming song titles is the bane of any composer's existence. If you're good at it, I hate you. Because like how many like my files that I outport to eventually what goes uploaded to you guys, they have all different names because I don't know what I want to name it.
Yeah.
And like maybe in the upload process, like I'll be thinking about something and I'll name it something else. But like,
mm-hmm.
I mean, I can like take a glimpse at what I name things right now. Like, I will spell things wrong constantly. Like it doesn't matter. Like,
I'm gonna turn this down just a little bit.
Yeah. Again. What does sad flute mean to you? It means nothing to me. I have a song called Bach Riff Off because they just did. you know. Getting Along, probably my favorite theme, doesn't match. I mean, suits the mood, but doesn't suit the music, you know what I mean?
Mm-hmm. This bit that's playing right now with the guitar is the battle theme from the original Crystal Tower raid, too. And I love that. There was so much thought that went into this. And I wish more people realized that, like, how much effort and time goes into not just the music, but, like, the little whoosh when we're on the platform. Like, somebody had to design that sound.
Yeah. That's true. All the attack sounds as well.
Mm-hmm.
The abilities, effects, and stuff like that. Some of the sounds in this game, like, are deeply rooted within me. Like, the tell sound.
Yeah.
I can't get that out of my head.
Yeah, my roommate had the tell sound for her messenger theme for a long time, and I always had this, like, head jerk of, like, who sent me a DM?
Yeah, exactly. I used it, too, as well, as a notification sound for a while. What else? The paladin tank stance.
Mm.
Since that's also used in Seed of Sacrifice as you know, the phase transition and activating abilities and stuff like that. That kills me so hard.
Actually,
every time I hear a paladin in a little dungeon turning it on.
Mm-hmm. I've never actually read these.
Oh,
Our only hope lies in the Crystal Tower, though it did not yield its secrets easily. Even opening the doors was a monumental undertaking. Without the Founder's data logs and the no reports left by the Sons of St. Koina, we never would have stood a chance of succeeding. I'm pretty sure that the data log 2.5 is a reference to patch 2.5 when this came out, too.
This came out in, 4 point something.
No, the Crystal Tower raid series,
Tower.
when they shut him in the tower, would have been 2.5 if,
right.
Raid trends had continued.
I believe that's correct, yeah. That makes sense.
Huh.
But yeah, this dungeon is sort of like, you know, all that process. It's about time travel. It's about, you know, shifting through space and stuff like that. And
mm-hmm.
I think that's why it's so cool that they unite all these themes and remixes of a remix. Like,
yeah.
It's so wild. I do hate that they stopped playing this music during boss fights. It does make me so upset.
Yeah. I'm just gonna enjoy this for a little bit. I've read this listened to this so many times, but it never gets old. Oh yeah, I was gonna open up with what are y'all's favorite songs? Hard mode, not this one.
Oh, come on.
Easy. Honor fades a light. Slaps.
Where's that one from?
Don't remember, because remember, I don't listen to in-game music. I listen to a lot of things. It sounds like your typical fantasy town music.
What soundtrack?
From Shadowbringers.
Shadowbringers? Okay.
Yeah. I was telling Miles about it. It's okay.
Miles, how about you?
I really like Tomorrow and Tomorrow, the Shadowbringers main theme.
Mm, me too.
I think it's just really beautiful. Like, it moves me every time I hear it.
Mm-hmm.
I think besides that, I like, I don't know the name of the song, but it's a really hype song from Shadowbringers as well. It's when you, like, you're gonna do something, and it's, like, the very, like, heavy guitar riffy song.
Mm, I think I know the one.
Yeah? Do you know the name?
Let me see if I can find it. It will pop out at me, I'm sure.
Now, real quick, do you have a least favorite song?
Do I have a least favorite song?
Yeah,
actually. Let me find it. It's a playlist.
Besides To the Edge for personal reasons. let's see. I don't know. Maybe like the joke about music or something.
My least favorite is called A Reason to Live, and it is the Ilmeg and Tamra town themes.
Oh, okay.
That, like, obnoxious. I never did like that theme song.
Gotcha.
It just something about the way it was made, I've never really liked it.
Yeah, that's understandable.
However, Fierce and Free, which is the theme for Ilmeg as the field theme, one of my favorites in the whole Shadowbringers soundtrack.
Yeah. Oh, Wind on the Plains. I very much like Fantasia.
Wind on the Plains and, what's the other one called? The Battle Theme. Oh, I forget what the Battle Theme for Baja is called, too, but that one's really good, too.
That one's also really good. I also like A Fine Air of Forsyth from PvP.
Mm, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, like as much as I dislike PvP, the music does slap, and I hate that about it.
Yeah, it gets you pumped. That's what I like about, like, when music gets me pumped, that's when I'm having fun.
Yeah.
My least favorite song is More the Truth At me, don't at me. That is the song played when any type of sad or dramatic things happen in a cutscene.
Yeah, that's fair.
God, it's, you had, man, as somebody who is, like, melded to, like, smash the X button as soon as I see a cutscene, and when I hear that song, it just, it increases the speed as much as I can. I just, like, full on.
Yeah, definitely. Anywhere else? Ooh, you know where I like? Let me take you there.
Yeah.
I like this song here. I'm going to take us to this place. I hope it's playing right now. There's two songs. I'm going to take you two places. This is the first one.
Ooh.
Also Shadowbringers area.
Yeah. Thank you for paying my teleport fee.
I was about to say, ooh, that big teleport money. Damn.
Yeah.
You want to know the Shadowbringers area? Oof.
I really
like these coffee biscuits for you, dude.
I have so many. I don't turn them in.
Girl, I'll get your money back.
Yeah, this is a good area. We're at the inn at Journey's Head Care.
Oh, gotcha, yeah.
I like the Amarang music so much.
Me too. I don't have a mount on that hopper anymore. I really want to show off the Amarang field music too.
Yeah.
Oh, I should... Here. I have a two-seater.
Ooh, a good question when you guys are flying over there. Do you guys have flight music on or off?
Off.
Like mount
off.
Music. Yeah? Okay. Same.
You have all music off, though.
Yeah. True. But it's just like, because one of my favorite mounts is that Shiva horse.
Mm.
Yes.
And hearing that theme over and over, like more than two times, I'm like, okay, I think I'm done forever. Thank you. I appreciate all the time and work that got into this, but all right.
Yeah, Amarang, I'm sorry. I think out of all of the field music, with the exception of Amarat, is my favorite.
Hmm. You don't like the Amarat field music?
I do. Like with.
Or the, I guess, not Amarat, but like.
Neath Dark Waters, I think
yeah,
is.
Yeah, you don't like Neath Dark Waters.
Yeah.
It's one of my favorites. I'm saying aside from that one, Amarat's my favorite.
Oh, aside. Okay, got you. Yeah, this one's just like, it's just so chill.
Mm-hmm.
I very much enjoy that about this.
And, like, I really should go into New Game Plus so I can show off that sound effect. But before you restore night to the area, and there's, you know, the everlasting light shining down from above, the music will pause and have this kind of, like, unsettling ringing sound.
Yeah, I think I know what you're talking about.
Yeah. And it's those little touches that make you realize just how dire the situation is.
Just like the eerie unsettlingness of it all.
Mm-hmm.
All right, this was the first place.
Okay.
I'm gonna take you to the other place, and I think this is quite a favorite. I'm gonna go to my preferred place here.
Okay. Where are you going?
We'll find out.
Oh. Are we talking the town music or the field music?
The field music.
Yeah. I hate that it's become such a meme too.
It's a meme. It's a good meme. I like it. I like the town music too, though. It's mm-hmm. a really nice song.
It is.
But come on, like, oh, I remember back when we were in the first FC, we like met each other in. Like, I literally heard this song playing on the orchestrion because they were ahead of the story on me. And I'm mm-hmm. like, what is this song? I love this Civilizations, the Lahi sound song. Like, it's so good.
It really is. And then Unwound is the dungeon theme for the Katana Ravel.
Yeah, I was listening to that one earlier too. That one's so sweet. You want to go in there after
this?
Yeah, let's do that.
Sorry, Kara, I'm not like trying to exclude you.
No. Please. Exclude like away.
This song has the distinction of being on both a sleep time playlist and a workout playlist. Not Whoa. Civilizations, but... the one we're going into. Oh, hey, I can be mounted in here?
Yeah, you can be mounted in here. Can I ride
this? This is Malika's well.
This is Malik as well.
I didn't mean to use my potion. Damn it. This is not the right one.
Right.
It's been a long day.
No, it's okay. They're like right next to each other too.
Yeah.
Why did it put us here? Slitherbow. That's strange.
I don't know.
Okay, that's weird. I thought it would release us where we just were, but it
you,
just
you would
us
think, but I quirk of the game.
Is that a bug?
No, it's a feature.
Oh.
Todd this Howard is... programmed that one in personally.
Oh, all right.
Wow, did he? Yeah, Howard.
There we go. This is the Katana Rabble. It's funny how the starting area for both of those looks similar too.
They do.
Gosh, I love this look. I should take some screenshots.
Mm-hmm. But like to kind of re-emphasize what a leitmotif is, you get that da-da in here too. And that throws back to the civilizations piece.
If the Lahi is too much for you too, the night theme for the Raktigi Ray Woods is very good too.
It's beautiful. Mm-hmm. I'm pretty sure that was Keiko performing that one.
Yeah.
She does most of the piano collections. And we're going to talk about the design of this dungeon at some point too, because holy crap. It's so good.
It's really cool.
I think I have dungeons on... what, Friday? No.
Thursday?
Yeah. Tomorrow.
Tomorrow.
I'm showing your Bible.
It's such a pretty. It's such a. It's so intricate, and like I wish that I had the technical expertise that Alex does to break this stuff down. Because he talks about like in this section here, where there's no percussion. It's like a break from the music, mm-hmm. and it keeps you from getting worn out on it.
Yeah. And I think that's really important, especially in a game where like you have the ability to set these songs as sort of like the ambience of a place and stuff like that for housing or apartments or whatever.
Yeah.
And I think that's good at keeping the songs like fresh always. Like they don't tire you out of listening to them. Because that's what I hate sometimes about songs. Like after I hear it for so long, I'll just be like, enough.
Yeah.
And I feel like I can listen to these songs a lot longer than regular ones.
And it helps too, like in the overworld music, that they kind of are... They're staggered a little bit. It's not just constantly playing. Mm-hmm. So you don't have to, like... It's not like you have to sit and listen to the same thing over and over and over 1,000 times while you're doing something there. And I know some people prefer the continuous music.
Yeah.
But I really do think that it keeps it from getting stale.
Yeah, I think so, too.
I see you get my character an MP3 player now!
Yeah, Pocket Orchestrians when...
Pocket Orchestrians. That sounds like a great idea.
Right?
Yeah. Make your own playlist.
Where you're doing whatever you need to do.
That's amazing. Sweet. I like that.
Give now to me, please.
Heidelin Kick.
Orchestrals. Where you go. Yeah, Heidelin Kick. Heidelin Slam!
I remember they were talking about cross data center travel. And this can't have been more than a year or a year and a half ago. But the phrase that Yoshida used was, it would take a Heidelin kick to make it work. But now look at them.
Now look at them.
Yeah, they're working on it. Like, once they get the supply chain thing figured out, and, like, figure out where all the semiconductors are.
This view, as you come out of the cave...
Oh my gosh, right?
And you see that tree, that massive tree in the distance, and the light sort of pouring down from the canopy... That's beautiful. I love that.
Yeah, so they really outdid themselves with the 5.0 dungeons.
We should leave because This is just gonna be stealing from tomorrow's
yeah.
theme.
I have some place I wanna show off too.
Ooh, yeah, let's go.
From way back in A Realm Reborn.
Oh, yeah, 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 let's go.
I'll wait for you to get here.
I'm here.
It is...
Oh, it dropped you off
yeah.
at the point there, but it dropped me off over here.
Yeah, for some reason.
Bizarre.
Did it give you the teleport?
Yes.
Okay. We'll have to do some traveling for this. Oh, you're on. So, I didn't realize you could... Like, I completely forget that this area is even over here. Because I never go over here. But I was I was either here or in one of the, like, connected areas leveling a gatherer. And the music came on. And I went, oh my god, what is this? And it's part of a bigger track called On Westerly Winds. And I think it's a genuine tragedy that this is not its own standalone theme. Let's see if it plays.
Yeah, it's outer Lenosha. You can go here from the north of Aleport.
This one. Let me turn it up a little too.
Or upper Lenosha, not outer. Outer is even norther than this.
You can find this if you search for a Raincatcher Gully on YouTube. Mm-hmm. And I think somebody put up an extended version of it. Not that I'm saying you should use illicit music, but there are methods.
This is a really good track.
Mm-hmm.
It's very... You know what feel it has for me, and I always thought this, was that it felt a little like Dot Hack.
A little bit, yeah. It has that Yoko Kanno era. God, I'm drawing a blank on Yuki Kajiure, that's what her name is, that did all the Dot Hack music. She definitely had this kind of style, and I think this is an Uematsu track, if I'm not mistaken.
It would make sense since it is from that time.
Yeah, it's from way, way back in the very beginning. And, like, Soken kind of, like... They kind of split the difference on at least through 2.0 before he took over fully so that Uematsu could focus on other projects. I think actually that was when he like stepped back for his health.
Gotcha.
Which is fair because like as much music as had to go into this game, that would take a toll on anybody.
Yeah
like one of my absolute most favorite tracks in this whole game is like I think my favorite track in A Realm Reborn.
It's really pretty. I think it like has this feeling of mystery to it.
And you can completely miss it, too.
Yeah, absolutely. Because you barely come here.
Yeah.
And when you come here, it's always to do something very annoying. Mm-hmm. So I'm sure anyone that comes here is doing something and they're very frustrated about it.
Yeah. And like I said, I think it's really tragic that this isn't its own bigger standalone piece because I think it deserves to be.
Oh, for sure. Yeah, I could totally see that.
Yeah, the track it's from is called On Westerly Winds, and the whole track is really pretty. I think Lenostia has my favorite music overall. I'm trying to think where else.
I think I'm down with that, yeah. I like the Lenostia music. I also like this. I like some of the Gridania music as well.
True. I'll always have a very special place in my heart for Gridania because that's where I started way back as a wee baby archer.
I started in Limsa.
Gotcha. Yeah.
So started in Gridania. When I played a part.
Oh, I'm going to take us to Foundation because I want to point out something. I forget that it does that.
Yeah, me too. I hate when it does that.
But yeah, something funny that got done with, so, like, they recently crossed over with Nier Automata, and, like, the Nier series as a whole for the Alliance raids. And then I guess there was an ad for Final Fantasy 14 in the physical version of the Nier remake.
Okay.
And it'll play Final Fantasy up to level 60, including Heavensward. And I want everybody to listen to this one really closely. Just briefly. And then I'll send you the link, Maus.
Okay.
That's what it's called. And I'm gonna tempt fate here.
Oh yeah.
I'll send it to you too, Care.
Thanks.
Oh, okay, okay.
Is that coming up on a...
This is terrifying to look at.
I'm so sorry.
Yeah, that imagery is...
I'm so sorry.
Not sleeping tonight. I want to fix my sleep schedule, but that's
You can
over.
Skip to about... That's too far. To about 30 seconds in. It's coming up, it's a little too soon. It's about 60 seconds in.
Yeah, let's let people like program drums like that, or just have drums like that.
Yeah. All of this to say is that they snuck in the Ishgard town theme into the Nier soundtrack.
That's awesome.
I really hope that doesn't get me pinged for copyright infringement, but we'll see.
No, you should be fine.
Yeah.
But yeah, like just that little.
You don't plan on keeping the ball.
And I'm really sorry for the terrifying thumbnail. That was just the first one I grabbed. I thought it was like a video of the boss fight. Because that was new in the Nier remake.
Yeah.
Alex did a breakdown of that one too. It was pretty great.
You know.
Go ahead.
All right. I was going to say, now that we're here, there's another song that I really like.
Which one?
In this area. Let's go to the front for a minute.
Oh. I do enjoy the firmament. We have a day dedicated to the firmament and the fets and stuff. Might have to shuffle that one around a little bit.
Yeah.
Depending on when they start.
I really like this firmament song.
Mm-hmm. It feels...
I don't know what it's called.
Oh, I was just looking at this too. It's called... I believe it's called Skyrise.
Skyrise.
Mm-hmm.
Is it an orchestrion? I need to get it.
I'm not sure. But yeah, it definitely has that kind of overall overarching emotion of we're done. We accomplished it. Good job, everybody. Sit back, relax, and enjoy the hard work you put in.
Yeah, absolutely. It's very comfy. It's very happy. Especially for a place like Ishgard, where that's like not a thing.
Mm-hmm. This gives me the image of like preparing for a winter holiday almost. Like you're expecting, you know, good company, a good time. The mood is cheery.
Yeah, I totally get that from this too. wait for his card out.
Mm-hmm.
Literally the only reason I have any gil.
I wonder if they'll play the same song for it.
I really hope so.
I do too, but also I can't imagine them recycling such a specific track.
But it makes me so happy.
It makes me happy too.
They'll probably just do something lame, like make a new song.
Why would they do that? They have so many songs already.
And then there was one other one that I wanted to hit.
Yeah. Go hit something.
Let's go back into Explorer mode. So if anybody's ever seen the well, I guess they put it in 2002, but the original Fantasia had Mickey Mouse as the Sorcerer's Apprentice. And if you've ever seen that, and if you haven't heard the track, it's by Paul Dukas, D-U-K-A-S. Please do yourself a favor and look it up, and then come into this dungeon. Oh, is it your Nixie?
It's my Nixie.
I love Nixie. Oh, let's go in order. Oh.
Oh, okay.
Never mind.
See ya.
Oh, I'm coming.
No, I can go back.
No, I'm already there.
Alright. I like this one.
Yeah, it looks like Lisa Frank threw up on a volcano. Okay, so, like, we had to go stir the kiln up here. What about this one? This one's fine.
This one works. I don't know why we didn't go to this one. Maybe it's just not big enough?
Maybe.
That other one's huge.
Yeah, true.
That one's like three times the size.
True. Yeah, this bit with the high trumpets taken directly from that song. He was not subtle about it. And I don't say that as a detriment to him or, like, to call into question his ability as a composer. I think that's incredible.
Yeah, it's like, it's there. You want to evoke this feeling, this idea, it's there.
Well, and it's very on point thematically, too, because what is Ystola but the Sorcerer's Apprentice?
Exactly, yeah.
The song is called Freshly Baked Porksy, for anybody who's curious.
Oh, no. Why would you name it that?
Because we had to make a Porksy. They're made out of clay. Yeah.
All the Porksy's attacks are also references to, like, mincemeat and
yeah.
stuff like that.
And yeah, like, the original area is called, like, the Sorcerer's Interstice or whatever it's called. Like, they really, really emphasize that inspiration for both the dungeon and the music. And of course, I'm having flashbacks to my continuing days in the Kingdom Hearts fandom, too. Trying to get through
Absolutely.
The stupid tower. Which, while we're on the subject... Oh, go ahead, I'm sorry.
Yeah, I was going to say, I like this area, because
mm-hmm.
it also has that sort of Charlian Etruscan architecture.
Mm-hmm, with the spirals in particular.
Yeah.
While I'm thinking about it, another YouTube channel to subscribe to is called Project Destati. They're a sub-project of the Materia Collective. And they have a couple of albums out. They're like a 110-piece orchestra with a full choir that do nothing but Kingdom Hearts covers. And they, like, whether or not you're a fan of the series, the music is incredible.
Wow.
Yeah.
That's a huge, huge group.
Yeah. Yeah, they're gigantic. And they do really, really good work, too. Oof.
It goes.
Yeah, it's really hard not to, like, go completely off the rails and go into, like, dungeon design, too, because I love this.
Yeah.
Whatever this is back here.
It's like some kind of filtration system, I think.
Oh, yeah. That makes sense.
Yeah, because all this area seems like its whole purpose is irrigation and filtration. Mm-hmm. So it's like a water treatment plant.
Yeah. Ah, a water temple.
A water temple.
Oh, no.
But it's fun.
And Matoya's theme came all the way from Final Fantasy I. That was a character way back in the day. Her theme in this game is called the Mushroomery.
Yeah.
It's a good name for a theme.
It is.
It's a good name for a theme. It's a good song. It's just very short.
Yeah. Well, that was all her theme was originally. Was just like the two little phrases, and that was it.
Yeah.
It was not very big, and but you know they were limited on with the hardware limitations back then, of course. But
It makes sense.
Yeah, I've never like taken the chance to like look at the stuff on the shelves here either.
Lots of books.
Yeah, that's to be expected. Matoya's a nerd.
Ew, all this stuff is gross.
Yeah.
Hence why they need so much irrigation. And then this area.
This is another dungeon I want to touch on tomorrow, too. Mm-hmm. I love this dungeon. It was super lighthearted for... like, when it came out. I think we really needed that break.
Yeah, for sure. Especially between what was going on.
Yeah, the poor Mother Porksy taking a nap. Oh, she's twitching! Oh, God!
Yeah, they twitch.
Oh, no!
That means they're alive.
Oh, true,
still.
True.
If you look at the big pot thing in the background, if you look at the little chimney thing it's got at the top there, look at how it's bent. It's so bent.
Chimney thing.
On top of the giant fire furnace thing over there in the back, behind the exit.
Oh, yeah. I see
that's
it now.
That's some Disney.
It really is.
The way it's like a sharp bend like
yeah.
that.
Yeah, no, that's absolutely a Disney thing, you're right.
And there's more stuff in here, but I don't want to detract from tomorrow's.
Yeah. We'll get to it. We'll get to all of that tomorrow. Do we want to... go ahead.
There's trials. There's a lot of trials, too, that have some cool music in them.
Yeah. What's y'all's favorite trial themes?
It's a good question. There's a lot of really good ones.
Mm-hmm.
Let me look at the trials. I like the throat singing.
The what?
The throat singing in Ravana's.
Mm, me too.
In
I was about to say Ravana. Fuck.
Yeah. Sorry, Kerr.
Yeah, that's Ravana's okay. Is really good. The other one I was listening to today was Susano's.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, it's a lot of fun too.
Yeah, I really think that Stormblood and like particular like the Doman and Hingen areas were where Soken really got to be creative, because there were a lot of like national instruments that he could draw on for that.
For sure, like the songs for Tsukuyomi,
mm-hmm.
both of those were really good. I like Susaku's music. I even liked Seiryu's music as well.
Mm-hmm.
Byakko's was cool.
Yeah.
The Four Lords music is pretty much really good.
And to touch on Tsukuyomi's theme, they had a breakdown on one of the developer blogs about the contradiction between this like lone, light, female voice singing compared to all of this big choir of deep masculine voices singing in another language. And how that symbolism was really, really intentional. So they really do get a chance to do some subtle story building or storytelling with that. Let me turn this down again. I want people to hear. Yeah. They do that a lot too. And I know they don't really go into it too much, at least in the English version, but Susanoo in particular is like a very important figure in Japanese like Shinto stories.
Yeah.
So that he got a big, fun, vibrant, over-the-top theme for a big over-the-top fight and was all about, you know, we're all for the glory of battle and not about anything else.
Let's cue for it.
Yeah. Do we want to unsync it?
Of course.
Okay.
Also, you mentioned it earlier for Suzaku's theme, but I know I've like this is the second time I've shielded this album. The Pulse remix has Sunrise on it, Suzaku's theme, and slaps. Just get the Pulse album. Like I think it's worth it, or just like I think it's on YouTube as well.
I didn't care for some of them. But yeah, to get into this again, let me turn this back up so everybody can hear. The big booming drums in the background are called taiko, and if you've never seen them performed live, you should do so at your earliest convenience because they are incredible to see played live. Like, they have, you know, 6 or 7 of them. They, like, one of the conventions I used to work, they would, bring in the local, they had, like, a taiko. Like, it was a club, basically, but they learned from master musicians in Japan how to play them. And it was just some of the biggest energy I've ever seen from something that was just percussion.
Heck yeah.
Okay, 3, 2, 1, pull.
Get pulled early.
Can we do this with 2 people?
Yeah, of course.
Okay.
Probably.
Oh yeah.
Unless we both get jailed.
Posture check.
Welcome to the stream, DJ Amiya.
Welcome to the stream. I want to point out too the use of the shamisen here, that like twangy. Yep, I'm right here. That twangy stringed instrument that shows up. Hydrate. I'll do that after this.
Yeah, same.
There's a pair on YouTube, and I'll see if I can find them in my history. Just shredded on their shamisen. It was incredible. It was some of the coolest performance I'd ever seen.
You don't have to move.
Nope, I'm going to. I had a...
I put a black sign on you.
Oh, I'm so sorry.
It's okay. The sea's part for
we alone. I had a, an instant cast. I had a couple of them.
Gotcha.
I'm not gonna stack so you can get your proc.
No, I'll get it. So group does shamisen on YouTube?
I think they call themselves the Shamisen Girls, but I'll have to see if I can find it.
That sounds cool.
Yeah. Just absolutely shredded on these instruments. It was I can't put into words how cool it was to watch.
I love the lines that Susanoo says.
Me
so
too.
Much.
Somebody had that meme of from The Office where it was Ravana said somebody is about to die, and Susanoo's response was of fun.
What do you say?
I really, because when we were going through Eden and we saw sort of. Primal fusions with Flame Wingman, I mean Garuda and Ifrit. I was really
yeah.
hoping we get to see one with Ravana and Susanoo, because I think these characters...
Oh, that would have been so cool.
So well. Yeah, and it's like the absolute... The funnest fighter, I think,
mm-hmm.
would be the result.
Yeah. Oh, that was closer than I wanted to be. Oh, well.
I still want that. I still want to see a fusion of those two.
Mm-hmm. Resilient souls, I salute you. And that leitmotif coming up again of that little trilling melody. Uh-oh, I'm in jail. I've been jailed. I'll tell you which one I'm on.
Yeah, I'm good.
Nice stacks. That wasn't what I wanted to do. Right, I need to get out of that. Nobody comment on how badly I'm playing Black Mage tonight, please.
Yeah, it 1000% is Flame Wing Man.
Yeah.
I make that joke every time I go into that fight. I'll be like, and now I activate polymerization using my two elemental heroes together and forming Flame Wing Man.
Gotta say the elemental hero's name. He never disrespects him like that. Although he does, but.
He's having fun.
He's having a good time.
Yeah, I like this here too. When you finish the fight, sort of the raindrops in the air are kind of like hanging around. I think that's so pretty.
Don't forget your hydrate.
Oh yeah, yeah.
I want to see something, and like I really do like this area's music too. We're gonna go to Idleshire first.
Ooh, yes. Oh, but it's nighttime.
Yeah, but the nighttime music is really pretty.
The nighttime music is really pretty.
When I did that the first time, I screamed that out, and no one else knew who Flame Wingman was, and I was sorely disappointed. Oh no.
Oh no. It's okay. Same thing with me.
Yeah, I think this is my favorite night theme, at least from this expansion.
Oh, you mean like in the hinterlands?
Yeah.
Oh, gotcha.
But also, I want to go show off Matoya's cave.
Crow, do you ever just imagine yourself in the place of Stola? Like, complete, like, Stola doesn't exist, it's just Crow.
No, I imagine myself in the place of Matoya a lot, though.
Oh, okay, okay.
That,
so
I
you're
keep hitting
like,
that button.
Mentor. Are you using...
I okay, that was...
four teachers?
I'm not meaning to. That button is where my Mount Roulette used to be.
Grade 4 tinctures just being used like nothing.
I didn't mean to. I've only done it a couple of times. I want to see if the time stop thing around Alexander is true. I haven't had a chance
to
look
at.
Oh, the
river stopped?
I haven't had a chance
to
look at.
Yeah, let's go check that out. I mean, at least they're using them, right?
Leave me alone. Being bullied on my own stream.
I know what it feels like to be lying.
Yeah, right? Nobody's bullied more on their own stream than me.
Oh, yeah. Look at that.
Yeah, the water just doesn't flow in there.
That's super cool. Like, you can see the breakwater and everything, too.
Mm-hmm. Poor Mide. And Mide's boyfriend.
Yeah. But also, I really can't wait for that Perfect Alexander t-shirt.
Ooh, heck yeah.
Alexander's been my favorite summon from, like, when I played... Final Fantasy IX was the first Final Fantasy game that I ever played, like, bought with my own money and played on my own without help from an older friend or cousin or anything.
Yeah.
So, Alexander has always been my favorite summon.
Oh, so that's why.
Yeah. Little baby meme on my PlayStation 2. Playing this old game.
Is Final Fantasy IX your favorite non-14 Final Fantasy?
I think so, yeah.
Nice.
What is yours, Lahaim?
Mine's probably Final Fantasy III.
Where the heck is this cave?
It's to back. Go back.
Dang it.
And then go, yeah.
Yeah, I see now. Ooh, a vista. I should get that at some point.
Gross. Delete it.
Oh, I see it now.
I hate the vista quests, if y'all don't know, because I accidentally pick them up all the time. And it's not one of those quests that asks if you want it or not. It just gives it to you, and you can't abandon it either. So now you're just cursed with it forever. Actually, three. actually three, yeah. When they like did the remix, they like went nuts and I bought it again. I'm like, I love this so much. With Doga, Une, you know, the first go around of like the expanded job system and stuff like that. The Crystal Tower, all those things.
Can we unsync the Crystal Tower?
I don't think it'll let us in, but we can try.
Yeah, this is Montoya's theme. Could just queue up for it.
Yeah, we could just queue up for it.
I don't want to spend I don't want to spend the time though.
That's fair.
And it's a Crystal Tower specifically that I need. Because that has that theme from the Twinning.
Do you have the Orchestrion?
Oh, I don't think I do. Let me check.
Do you know what it's called?
I have one of them, but I don't think it's the right one. Yeah, I have Shattered and I have Eternal Wind, and I don't think that's the ones.
Are you sure it's not Eternal Wind?
No, it's a different one. Eternal Wind is the big giant spoiler that they stuck into the Shadowbringers trailer.
Yeah.
Which, it had been so long since I last played that Raid series that I had entirely forgotten about him.
That's like, you never queued for Alliance Raid then.
Well, no, like, I had done those cutscenes so long ago.
Oh, okay, gotcha.
Shattered is Zandy. Yeah, I thought so. Yeah, I think the one I want is either I Know the Truth or Out of the Labyrinth.
Okay. Let me see if I can go buy those.
Let's see. Here.
Let's go to...
It will not.
The Crystarium.
It will not let us unsync this.
That's disappointing.
It is. I'll come with because the Crystarium music is good too.
Oh, you know where else is a nice song? And I'll try and go there quick. After this, let me just check the market. What are the songs called? I Know the Truth.
I Know the Truth and, I had it. Out of the Labyrinth, I believe.
Now I Know the Truth. Bought it.
Are they expensive?
No. And Out of the Lab. Yeah, these are cheap.
Helps if I can spell.
I can just trade these to you.
I can't spell Labyrinth, apparently.
Let me trade.
Thank you. Thank you.
Mm-hmm. I don't think I actually have them, so I'm going to go and pick them up, too.
Oh, okay. Oh, do you have Fortress of Lies?
That's my life. Let me see.
From the Nier Raids?
Yeah, I'll check. I probably do.
If you don't, would you like it?
Oh, sure.
So I have an extra one. I think I have an extra one.
I wrote Fortress of Life. You said it's from Raids?
Yeah, it'll be the second Raid tab.
I surprisingly think I do. I might not.
There you go.
Surprised. I thought I had every song.
What was your other location?
Oh, you don't want to play the song first?
Oh, yeah. Can I do that at the pendants?
Yes. Other way.
I'm going back to the
There's one over here.
Oh, right. I'm already on the halfway there. I don't know my way around the Crysterium very well.
Labyrinth.
It's this way.
I don't and know the truth. Don't. Okay, I'll buy these two as well. Good thing they're cheap.
Mm-hmm.
One of my goals on Malice, at least, is to collect as many of the orchestrals as I can.
Noble and expensive goals.
That's not it.
At least as many of the ones I can get for free.
Yeah.
That works. This one works.
I spent a lot of gil and a lot of MGP just picking up a bunch of songs, a lot of company seals, a lot of wolf marks.
Mm-hmm.
Tater totes.
Yeah, this is the same melody as was in the twinning. And then this is probably, I think, my favorite track in this whole game.
Which one is it?
The Weight of the World Prelude version.
Oh, gotcha, gotcha.
And I want to talk about the second of the Nier raids and how brilliant thematically it was to combine the Dark Colossus Destroys All from Automata with Torn from the Heavens from Final Fantasy. Because we're playing in the Yorha bunker that was literally torn from the heavens when it fell out of orbit.
Yeah.
Just...
That's true.
Soken's a genius.
They really are.
Yeah, I wasn't sure how they were going to top this one with that raid series, but they really, really did. I'm not gonna listen to this whole thing. Alex McCullough does a really good breakdown of it. But it's so good. So there's an interesting phenomenon called the Mondegreen effect, where if you're hearing something that you can't quite tell what it is, and you get the idea of it saying a specific thing, you will start to hear that thing. And like, people were doing that with some of the Breath of the Wild trailers. Breath of the Wild sequel trailers.
Oh, okay.
Where somebody found spoken words that had been put in, but they were reversed. And so people, you know, reverse engineered it, and they played with all the sound levels and stuff, and mostly isolated it, but it was still really distorted because it was reversed initially. And they talked about how, like, yeah, the Mondegreen effect convinced people that it was saying something when it may not have been. But the second... Da, 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 da. In that song, I swear I can hear it saying glory to mankind. Glory to mankind.
I hear it, yeah.
Which I'm pretty sure it's not, because they used more of the chaos language from Nier, but also it definitely wouldn't surprise me.
Speaking of the chaos language, one, I think it's so cool. Secondly, I think I really like the song Voice of Reason.
Mm-hmm.
That, like, it's so sad.
Yeah.
Such a sad song, but I like it a lot. I'm gonna take us to that place else, I'm out. But I really love the music that plays the Crysterium, by the way.
Me too.
The song that plays here in the Dravanian Forelands is really cool too.
Mm-hmm.
The night music. It's really pretty.
Is it the same night and day?
I don't know.
No, it's not.
It might be different.
Yeah, it is, but it's the same melody.
Yeah. But yeah, the Dravanian Forelands music is really cool too.
Mm-hmm. While we're here, there's a beast tribe in this area.
Yeah, the Vath.
And it took me a solid half hour of just scrolling through each song in the Heavensward soundtrack to find their music.
Oh yeah?
But it's so interestingly done. Kara, I'm so sorry we don't have more for you right now.
Oh, it's fine. I'm just like, this is a joy because it's just like I just get to listen to my friends talk about things that they like.
That's fair.
Which is sort of just an enjoyment to me.
Mm-hmm. That's fair. The 5G tower.
The Kurtha's Western Highlands music is your favorite. The Black and White Talk, the night theme. We should go check that out soon.
Yeah.
All night.
Let me dip down in here.
Ooh, the song.
Lost Asvath and the area where the Nath are have some really interesting percussion in particular. Kurtha's West. But yeah, it took me way longer than I wanted it to. Oh, another vista. I have to remember these.
Fuse.
Oh my god, I just left you. I'm so sorry.
Oh,
I'm
so okay.
Sorry.
It's okay. It's okay. It's okay. I have to teleport. I think it would be really cool, like, just to go off slightly. It's that person's name is GeForce NVIDIA. It's funny. Just going off track a little bit because I like to reference other games because that's what I do. Genshin Impact is a way you can like set down markers on your map.
Mm-hmm.
I think that would be cool if they introduced that here as well.
Yeah,
so
I agree.
Can set down points on the map, like special gathering points or points you just like to visit or where vistas are. And you can revisit them later. Like flagging, but more permanent.
Yeah.
So the song here is called Black and White.
It's so...
There's a statue of a dragoon over there towards the east that I really like.
Towards the east.
Yeah.
Oh, I see him. It's such a lonely area, too, and the music really emphasizes that. Oh, another vista.
Yeah.
And there's a person here. Oh, no, that's a...
There's a person. Oh, there's a dude that maintains this thing, I think.
Yeah.
Song reminds me of those nights right after a snowstorm, and it all settled down and quiet. Aww.
It really does. Oh, that's a good way to put it.
Yeah.
It's like being snowed in kind of feeling.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know which way I'm going. And there's that
bridge over there too.
I think I got that one.
Murray, Kara, and I jumped on that one forever during night seeing day. It was awful.
Yep. God.
And there's that theme, that melody from the opening video too.
Yeah, which I don't think that trailer song is like anywhere other than just that the trailer.
I don't think it is either.
Yeah, like I looked it up too because I really like the Heavensward trailer music, but it's not anywhere.
Yeah,
and, like I felt that was wild. Like even the like core song to it, it doesn't exist.
Huh. That is bizarre. It's such a pretty track.
Yeah, like the vocal part of it is just not anywhere.
Mm-hmm. Oh, I wonder if it was a contract thing, because that was when the voice actor strike was happening.
Maybe.
And like they just don't have the ability to release it.
Yeah, it has some like loose elements in other songs.
It is in
different places
in the credits, if I remember correctly. Oh, I'll have to check and see if maybe it's on like the bottom of the soundtrack then.
Yeah, we'll have to check because I really do like that Heavensward trailer song.
This is such a pretty area.
Definitely, yeah. It's wild to think that this place was all once lush and green.
Yeah.
And people lived out here and farmed and stuff like that. Now it's just all blanketed in snow.
Just a wasteland.
Yeah.
I was just going to say that.
And like all these corpses of these immense, like look at how like, big that dragon is just up there. That's huge. It's a huge dragon. Now it's just a bunch of really big bones.
Yeah. Makes it a little sad.
Yeah, it is sad, especially knowing now what we know of the Dragonsong War.
Oh, I just noticed those are giant dragon killers up there.
Yeah.
Holy
huge.
Crap. That's not the bridge. Those are dragon killers. Wow. And we'll talk about touches like that every day for overworld locations. I love Deep Eyes. They're so cute.
Really?
Hi, buddy. Yeah, look at him. Those little feet.
They do have little feet.
It's a graveyard. The song feels like it emphasizes that, too. Yeah, it really does.
Very much so. I agree.
Aw, little Sprout just getting here for the first time. Godspeed, kiddo. Yeah, what an incredible location for one of the first places you visit in the very first expansion.
Yeah.
Just amazing.
I like the music in East Shroud too.
Yeah?
Although it's more the day music, I think, that I like.
Oh, okay. Well, it's about to be day.
It's about to be day in a couple of in-game hours. And there was a place in Vanillan as well that I really liked the music to, but I don't remember which one it was.
Hmm. Oh, I just realized I can't do that in midair, can I?
The teleport?
Yeah.
It'll kick me out and push me to the nearest ether, right?
Okay.
But it'll still give me the the free teleport.
I'm so glad it doesn't just like drop you.
Yeah, I would just die. Well, I mean, I would land and probably live, but if I were a lower level, I would die.
While we wait for daylight, I love Little Solace.
Yeah, the Little Solace has its own music.
Mm-hmm.
It's great. All the tribe areas have their own little songs. Mm-hmm. That's awesome. Because they really are like settlements. They're like places that people live in.
Mm-hmm. Oh, I never have seen this waterfall before.
It's a nice waterfall, yeah.
Yeah.
Go from one side to the other.
Your mount can fly no higher. Okay. That's Soulflands. We don't want to go there.
Trying to think of other songs. Equilibrium from Sophia is nice.
The Warring Triad themes are all good.
Yeah. The Black Wolf Stalks Again from Emerald.
Hmm.
Also really cool.
You want to jump into Sophia?
Sure.
Undersized. In Heaven's Word. It is this one. Yeah, they remixed this one on both the Pulse album that you keep talking about, Care.
Yes.
And they had the Primals album that came out. It was on that one too.
Right, with the Primals album.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and again, the lyrics to this one are also really poignant too. There was somebody at FanFest China cosplayed Sophia, and it was incredible.
It was ridiculously
It was so good. Lakshmi won, which I think Lakshmi deserved the win. But Sophia was definitely a very, very close second. Like, those were some incredible pieces of costuming.
Yeah, both of them did such an awesome job.
Mm-hmm. Brings me back to being a 13-year-old and screaming, "What are those things?" All right, you ready?
Sure, let's do it. I'm like a little bit freaking out because I remember doing the solo farm of this.
Oh yeah, I remember you say watching you do that. But wasn't that extreme?
That was I solo farmed extreme. But,
oh, this is nothing.
But gosh, that was an awful time.
Ow. Yeah, but you did it. Didn't you do it as a scholar, too?
No, I did it as Dark Knight.
Oh, okay. On on Grail?
On Malice. On Malice.
Oh, I'm talking about... Didn't you do it on Grail, too?
No, I did on Malice.
Oh, okay. I thought I remembered watching you. I could be wrong.
I did... I went on Grail afterwards to do Omega. Yeah, I did. Let's do Sophia Farm first, and then afterwards let's go finish the Omega storyline on Grail.
Gosh, what a cool effect!
Yeah, right.
Oh, we can
now
fall off
the
edge
here. Now we can fall
off.
Yep. Can you bring sin must be balanced with suffering.
I'm gonna hold off a little bit so we can get more of the music.
Okay.
This is a very quick fight otherwise. Be the bearer of my wisdom. And see, that's an interesting thing for her to say because Sophia was the Gnostic concept of wisdom.
She has a knockback, I just don't remember when. Does that if she does that in the normal.
Yeah.
I'm just scared about it. This part of the song I really like.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, again, these are definitely worth going and listening to without worrying about a battle.
Yeah. Also, this arena is just very pretty, too.
Mm-hmm.
I like the constellations and stuff you can see in the distance.
Oh, yeah. I should have stayed and looked.
Yeah, sort of like we're floating up in, like, the stratosphere or something. There's these immense, like, stones. I call them liths or something.
Mm-hmm.
All over the place. You can see a bunch of scales floating around. The sun on the distance.
Mm-hmm.
It's really pretty in here.
Yeah. So, while we're waiting for the last few minutes before dawn here in the East Shroud, I had talked about how they used the adaptive music like that. Where it cycles between day and night. I think the music is the same here during day and night, though.
Well, this is the day music, so.
No, it was the same a minute ago before it was day.
Yeah, so if it's the same, it's the same. Which, this is the song I like, because you can hear all, like, the ambient chirping and stuff like that as well with it.
Mm-hmm. It's very peaceful. Like, it's
very peaceful, that's what I like about it. It's like, it's got a feeling of tranquility.
Mm-hmm. If I go tank and you go healer, what do you think our odds are of clearing a Phantom Train with two people? Normal.
If you go tank and I go healer?
Yeah.
We could probably do it, yeah.
Because that's another maybe. One. Like, I had written down throwbacks to older Final Fantasy games. Mm-hmm. And that was directly from Final Fantasy VI.
Gotcha. Yeah, we could try it. I don't know if our DPS will be good, but...
we can give it a shot. It's under raids, isn't it? I don't remember which one it is.
Will it? What? Yeah, it should let us. Let's duplex it. We'll try. We're going to need a really good monk to join us, though.
Which, you know, I have my hang-ups about Final Fantasy VI, but this is one of the best battle themes that's ever been written. Yeah, I think we can do it. We'll show off the theme, if nothing else.
Yeah.
Oh, I forget this mechanic.
Apply directly to the forehead.
Oh, right, we gotta put the light on the...
Yeah, not quite yet. It's just going off.
Right.
Get the far one.
Okay. I hope that's close enough.
Yeah. Stack it up.
I keep forgetting that that's Nero in the background. It's like telling us what to do. You got it?
Yeah, good.
Phase here, right?
Alright, well, I guess I'm gonna get the suck.
Uh-oh.
Take me.
That sounds like a tank buster. It probably was.
Come back. Here. Dodge these.
Yep. This isn't too bad.
Yeah.
That was probably not the best place to leave that. Oh well.
Fine.
I meant for me.
Oh yeah, I could have taken the back.
Oops. Goodbye, train.
Goodbye, we beat it!
Yay,
yeah,
we did it!
Get out of here!
Congratulations.
We did
Shame.
It. Oh no! We didn't. That's a whole other train.
That's a whole... Where did this come from? I didn't even know there was other tracks.
This is such a cool fight.
It is.
Now we need to get hit by the ghost, right?
Yeah.
Hi, buddy.
I'm like Danny Phantom, go ghost.
suplex the train. Oh, that was a tank buster. Oh well. I've never actually tanked this.
First time for everything?
Yeah.
I had my mic muted for that, right?
I don't know. What did you say?
Oh, okay. No, I was like, you didn't hear any of the conversation I had with someone else.
No,
right?
No.
Okay, cool. I was like, that shouldn't be on.
Nope, you're good.
No,
what
no.
kind of shit you saying, bud? Damn.
Oh, okay, I got it.
Yeah, all of this to demonstrate that they went from the, like, what was this on originally? Super Nintendo? The chiptunes.
Famicom.
Yeah, from back in the... No, it was later than that. To this
oh,
big,
or
like...
This one specifically?
Yeah, this song. Specifically.
Oh, this song. Yeah, yeah. I think that's Super Nintendo.
Yeah. To whatever, like, hybrid orchestral rock, whatever you want to call this. Also, it's just a super fun fight.
It is.
I love the piano bit here. Like, just from a technical level, that takes a lot of skill. Soon.
Down to 20%.
That's the weather here. Dimensional disruption.
It's my favorite weather.
I tried to shoot the ghost, it didn't work.
Yeah.
Nice. Ah, I got an achievement.
Congrats.
Tankless job one, Dark Knight.
Oh, shit.
Dark Driver. Hey, congrats on I got a title.
Nice. We count that as suplexing the train.
Trying to think what else I wanted to cover. Aside from, like, freaking out about the Endwalker trailer again and, like, how much they packed into the music for it.
It's daytime. Let's go to Idleshire.
Okay. Oh, okay. Oh, the bagpipes.
I love these bagpipes so much.
They are very good. I don't think they're technically bagpipes, though.
Yeah, they might not be.
I do believe, and I could be wrong. Please, somebody correct me if I'm wrong. I do believe that's what's called an English horn. Where it's a similar kind of like that brassy tone as a bagpipe, but it doesn't have the drone underneath. I believe that's what that instrument is called. For those of you on watching the stream that didn't know this, I, for most of my life, wanted to like go into music education.
Musication,
exactly.
Musication instructor.
Yeah.
So yeah, like, being able to identify these instruments by sound was something that I learned to do just, you know, listening to the collection of music that I did growing up. Like, it was mostly video game and anime soundtracks, me being a nerd. But being able to explain, like, yeah, it's this instrument doing this thing made it a little bit easier to explain to, like, people not in the know what I was listening to. I do like the Idleshire theme.
I like it a lot. For me, I just, in my mind, imagine sometimes someone, some villain or someone is giving this high and mighty, lofty monologue, and then just this starts blasting, and, like, machinists fall out, and, you know, start attacking them.
This blasting from a terrible, like, car speaker as a whole bunch of goblins are hanging out the windows.
Yes.
Yeah, all this to say, the music in this game is very evocative at times, too.
I just love the idea of these, of this just interrupting things. I think it's so hilarious. Mm-hmm.
Goblin Beast Tribes, when?
Oh, please.
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 Yes, please.
They're in the thing. They're in the poster of the tribes.
I love the goblins.
Yeah, the goblins are great.
They're so good.
I require more tribes to do.
More tribes.
We're
gonna get Lopperitz, we better get gobbies.
I particularly love Brayflox.
Yeah, Brayflox is pretty great.
Our favorite little cheese thief.
Brayflox. I'm helping, they say, provoking the lizard monster to attack you.
I like that her name is Altox.
Yeah. Goblin naming conventions are fun.
They're so good.
Yeah.
Yeah, fun thing that I noticed about the goblins. If the name ends in an IX, an X sound, it's a boy. If it ends in an OX, an ox sound, it's a girl.
Yeah. And they have names or surnames are related to things that they do or have done.
Yeah, like Brayflox never shuts up.
Yeah, or they're also just all talk and no, you know, skill or whatever.
No substance.
Yeah, no substance. They were part of the Company of Heroes, which for the most part did suck.
Oh yeah, except she was, wasn't she? I forget about that.
Yeah,
that cracks me up.
Yeah.
See, this is why I made sure that you were able to come on for deep lore.
So I can remind people the Company Heroes sucks. My least favorite part of the Errol Morborn storyline.
Yeah. Yeah. That's fair. So yeah, did either of you have anything else to add?
You know this game's free up to level 60?
Yeah, I don't think anybody watching isn't already playing, but if you happen to stumble across this video at a later date, this game is 100% free to play until the end of Heaven's Word. That's such a long time.
That's so much.
That is two-thirds the upcoming level cap. That's the base game and the first expansion. Yeah, that's so much content.
It's 2 years worth of content. And just there's so much side stuff.
And
if you skip cutscenes, it's 3 months.
Those are rookie numbers. Hironobu Sakaguchi finished A Realm Reborn in 2 weeks and has finished Heaven's Word in 2 days.
True.
Yeah.
Apparently. I wonder if he's skipping cutscenes or if he just isn't sleeping.
Both.
Little A, little B.
Yeah, a little bit of both. But yeah, he's absolutely powering through it. Which I'm glad for.
I really like the whole music concert showcase he did at the last FanFest.
Mm-hmm. Me too.
That was amazing. I love that they like got costumed up and did the meme
for
the twinning.
I love that these weren't like dancers that they hired. It's just like, this dude's from accounting, this guy's from advertising or marketing, this guy's from HR.
Yeah.
And they have videos of them like practicing ahead of the concert. It brings me so much joy.
Yeah. Token going on stage and playing their automaton. Amazing.
I'm so glad he still has a good sense of humor after all these years of doing this.
Absolutely.
Like, you can tell that they have fun with what they do, too.
Oh, for sure.
Like just listening to the Idleshire theme, like, you can tell that he was having a good day when he came in and sat down and, like, started working on this piece. It's so joyful.
So fun. And then the new music that's coming out, too. Like, the Charlian music and all
it's
the different
so
places.
It's so good.
Oh, it's so good. I can't wait.
Shout out to the people who have been on the media tour, who have been like the absolute heroes the last couple of days, however long, whatever week or however long, who have been putting up just like the uncovered music. It's just like, this is the mid-battle theme or the mid-boss theme with no effects over it.
Mm-hmm.
These people are the heroes of our community. Oh, it's Leon.
Yeah, I think sort of like, I was talking about this with Kara earlier before we started too. I think like good music, you know, attention to detail and good music and stuff like that is sort of like the cornerstone of like any good game,
mm-hmm.
any good game franchise out there. I use like The Legend of Zelda as an example. Like, games that don't do so well, work on your music. Maybe
yeah.
It'll help.
Well, and that's the difference between, like, not to sit and compare two entirely different franchises, but like that's the biggest difference I think between the Zelda franchise and the Final Fantasy franchise is Zelda has always prioritized simple but high quality music,
mm-hmm.
whereas Final Fantasy goes for a lot more complexity and a lot more depth in their music. Zelda music is just fine. But I have a handful of Zelda tracks that I'll listen to every now and again compared to, like, my entire list of just the Final Fantasy XIV music that I will listen to regularly.
Yeah.
So I think that really is the difference between the two franchises is Zelda puts a lot more into other parts of its games, whereas Final Fantasy really focuses on, like, the player-facing aspects the most, I think, if that makes sense.
Yeah. But both of them do, like, leagues better than games that just don't care about.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. Koji Kondo is a very, very talented composer, and you'll never hear me say otherwise, but I do prefer Final Fantasy to Zelda just for that reason of I think there's more complexity and more going on in the Final Fantasy music.
Both franchises have a long way before they reach anywhere near as good as Animal Crossing's music, so they got some fucking shit to get on.
Oh yeah, if you need something to do during the wait before Endwalker and you have a Switch, the big patch coming out for Animal Crossing drops November 5th. And true. Sora is live in Smash Brothers too. So there is that.
Or you can keep throwing all your money at MiHoYo like me. Genshin.
Someone really likes KK Slider. KK Slider is the Mozart of our day.
True. Also, apparently there was that, what was it? It was, there was a BGM soundtrack collections for New Horizon.
Oh, nice.
If I'm not mistaken, it's 24 hours now.
Oh my god.
Wow. That's long.
Because I do believe that they added all day and night soundtracks.
Oh my god.
Yeah, it features the entire game's 24-hour track list.
Holy crap.
So, when you fucking go, just listen to that.
Literally the whole day.
Yeah, literally the whole day. And listen to that 27 times, then Endwalker's out, and you're all good.
I am going to give everybody just a little bit of homework for this, though, because the last thing I had on my list of ideas for today was the theme songs of each expansion. And I know that they haven't released a single for Endwalker yet. And they will. They'll get to it. Can I help this little Lalafell? Go away. I'm going to punt him into the pool. go and listen to the trailer again and like pay attention to the music as much as you can. Like around all the sound effects and the dialogue and stuff, because you can pick out each of the main themes from A Realm Reborn up through Shadowbringers. Like if you count Torn from the Heavens as the main A Realm Reborn theme, which you should, because that one's kind of Soken's calling card. Because I'm not going to sit here and like make everybody listen to a 6.5-minute video just to point out a few things. I'm not going to do that to you all. But I really do recommend that if you have a few minutes to spare sometime, go and do that. And really notice how they made everything tie together and how they made it one big cohesive track. Because the themes from the different expansions were so radically different that it really is a mark of his talent and his skills as a music producer to be able to do that and tie all of them together and make it feel cohesive like that. Mm-hmm. Definitely worth doing at some point. Also, Amanda Aiken is possibly the best decision that they've made as far as their music production goes in a while. She is so incredibly talented. I think that was everything I had for music. Go listen to the soundtracks on streaming. It's almost all available on streaming.
On your major streaming platforms,
yeah, Spotify.
Tidal, Apple Music.
Yeah. I guess, did either of you have anything else?
I don't think so. Not me.
Yeah, no, not me.
I am gonna piss off Care.
Don't fucking do it.
I'm about to do it. He just had a third album drop on Bandcamp today.
I'm big at the cost.
Yeah, please go check out Star Map to Dead Planets and Toll Frimbus both on Bandcamp or wherever you can stream music. That is the ambient tracks of a traveler searching for a home through the stars, or it's some of the selected themes from our D&D campaigns. Definitely worth checking out. Definitely go support an independent artist.
Support, it's free. Don't support it. Just download it.
Buy the albums.
Don't do it. They'll also be on streaming services soon, so.
The Bandcamp listing for this most recent one is Pay What You Will, too, which is, really sweet.
Yeah, and if you look at it, it says zero, so you can do that.
Yeah. And they can be used for content, too, right, Kier?
None of it's,
Yeah.
With that, it'll get you flagged, so you can use it for anything that you want.
Yeah, also check out Tolfrembus on that same Bandcamp, because that's our D&D music and it's amazing. Don't argue.
I can objectively argue.
You don't want to argue with me out of all people.
Oh, Crow, we've been over who wins these arguments before.
Don't listen to either of them. Go make your own opinions by listening to them.
Very true. Thank you. Yeah.
My personal favorite is Frog Bard.
Legendary.
I got a tip one time to talk to the bard. And I tossed him a few gold coins and asked him to play for me, and I got a point of inspiration from it.
Yeah.
And then, you know, after the session ended, I was like, wait, what's the frog's name? And you sent me some, like, hieroglyphic bullshit, and I was so mad.
It's his name, you ass!
His name is Toad Frogbus.
Yeah,
it's Toad Frogbus.
But that was in his own native language.
And we should probably be getting back to D&D sometime soon for the final section, final portion of the Rule of Nines.
You told me next week, Kerr.
Next week. Wednesday evening.
Yeah. Which means that next week for this streaming project, Wednesday and Thursday will be doubled up on Thursday. So that we do not interfere with D&D, because that is important too.
Hog.
Alright, I've embarrassed Kerr. Lahaim, your turn.
Oh, okay. Are you gonna do me, or do I do me?
It helps if I spell your name correctly.
Yeah.
Leave me alone. It's been a long day. Give us your spiel. What you working on?
Yeah, you can find me at twitch.tv/Lahaim, where I am playing through different games. We'll probably be back to Eastford, hopefully, next Monday to play through that with Care. So that's going to be a fun one, so tune in for that. If we don't do that, whatever. We can do Genshin. Point is, it's a Careheim Monday, and really, you're just coming for us, I hope. So tune in for that one on Monday. Friday, we're doing more Monster Prom with Liz, a.k.a. Booba Spice, and that's the stream where I swear and say lewd things. So that's one you want to tune in for. If
he also says lewd things during the Monday streams, he just never catches himself.
I say lewd things all the time, it turns out. I just don't realize it.
And it's really funny.
I'm sorry.
Don't apologize. It sparks joy.
I cry. On Sundays, I do Final Fantasy 14, and if we're going to be raiding, hopefully we'll be doing some prog on Sundays. If not, I'll come up with something like 5 minutes in advance, or maybe 5 minutes after the time it's supposed to go live. I don't know. We'll find out.
You can also use my list at any point.
Yeah, I might steal from Crow with permission.
Yeah.
So it's not stealing. But I can also go live anytime, whenever. I love going through Genshin's story and stuff like that, so I might do Genshin. Basically, my streams care about dialogue, story, lore, things like that, and combat. So if you, and maybe trading cards. So if you like any of those things, you'll want to tune in for my channel.
Yeah. Yeah. I think that was everything I had for music today. I assume all of you are already following me on Twitter. If not, you should be. So there's cat pictures, giveaways, stream announcements, charity updates, which if you have not donated to Extra Life, why not? It's such a good cause. Every dollar counts. Every dollar helps a kid in need. It stays local to me, at least. Goes to KU Pediatrics right here in Kansas City. We are leading up to the 10-day marathon of Endwalker, which will all be to benefit Extra Life and Children's Miracle Network Hospitals, which treats kids for free. So if you've ever known a sick kid, if you've ever been a sick kid, if you've ever had a sick kid, you know how important those kinds of services are. So please consider donating if you have anything extra. When we hit, I think 800 is the next challenge. And I did find out that my local grocery store sells the one chip challenge. So we might do that and like do some savage content while I'm suffering.
Kids can't wait.
The kids can't wait, but I sure can, as far as that one chip challenge goes. I'll do it for the children. tomorrow, I think I said it was dungeons. Yeah, tomorrow's dungeons, so we're going to talk dungeon design, real-world references and inspiration, themes in the dungeons, and a couple other things. Maybe some creature talk. We'll see if we can get Liz on for creature creation. Because that's her bag. So please look forward to it. And thank you all for coming out tonight and